Americans are facing a heart-wrenching choice this Thanksgiving. Here's a question: to see family and friends and potentially put them at risk, or stay home? AAA was expecting up to 50 million travelers this holiday, but that was before new guidance from the CDC. And their advice to you is stay where you are.
The reason is an alarming uptick in cases, including more than 172,000 new ones yesterday. More than 2,100 people were reported dead in that 24-hour period. That's the most in a single day since early May. Chris Van Cleve is at Reagan National Airport outside Washington. Chris, good morning.
Well, good morning. You can take a look behind me here and you can see what holiday busy looks like in Washington. The TSA says this airport has only recovered about 25% of its passenger traffic from pre-pandemic levels, but other airports across the country in Chicago, Dallas, Houston, Denver, several in Florida are at 60 to 70% of where they were before the pandemic. So people are traveling, but whether you were a go or a no-go this year, for many, that decision was not easy.
Despite the COVID warnings, Americans are on the move.
As long as, you know, everybody wear a mask, everything's clean, it's nice. I don't mind it.
More than 4 million have already passed through airport checkpoints, and TSA is expecting today will be one of its busiest since March.
Sometimes you're in a crunch and you got to do what you got to do.
You're going to see those barriers. If you go to any airport, they're going to be very similar.
TSA Administrator David Pekoski showed us some of the latest COVID protections in place, including plexiglass, officers in PPE, and new scanners.
Do you think people should be traveling?
I think passengers need to make a judgment. My job in TSA and my officer's job is to make sure that if you do choose to travel, we provide you as safe and as secure an experience as we possibly can.
Just last week, the CDC followed mayors and governors in urging people not to travel for Thanksgiving. Those arriving in Los Angeles starting this morning will be required to fill out a health form asking them to quarantine for 2 weeks or risk a $500 fine. And in New York City, police will be looking to enforce quarantine rules. Pia Duryea is driving to see her parents in Connecticut.
It was a really difficult decision to make. I respect what the CDC guidelines are. And it's made me think real long and hard about it.
Both are in their 80s and recovering from summer health scares.
I wanted to go see them because you see all these stories about people who wish they had seen their family members before they got sick.
But Philadelphia healthcare worker Samantha Halpern told her family to stay in St. Louis just 2 hours before their flight. As cases climbed, they decided this year would be a Zoomsgiving.
I'd rather not have them come for this Thanksgiving than risk not ever spending any future holidays with them from here on out.
Now, AAA expects up to 50 million people will go somewhere for Thanksgiving this year. The CDC is urging folks, if they do that, to wear a mask when they're around people they don't live with, particularly indoors. Our Dr. John LaPook suggested breaking up the Thanksgiving eating from the Thanksgiving socializing, meaning when the masks are off, separate, come together to socialize with masks on, ideally outdoors or in well-ventilated spaces. Tony?
It's going to be a personal decision for every family, but those CDC guidelines are clear. Chris, thank you very much.